So to limit climate change to well below 2 degrees, lies in the Paris Agreement, we need to bring the emissions, the global emissions of carbon down to zero. And we know how to do this across a range of activities, renewable energy, electric cars, and so on. But there's emissions that we don't know how to bring down to zero. Agriculture, for example, or aviation is another example. And so our report looked at how the technologies that we can implement to take CO2 out of the atmosphere and put it on the ground, so remove CO2 from the atmosphere, the reverse process of the emissions. We looked at a range of technologies and we found that it is possible to bring the emissions down to zero, but it's hard work. It has, we have a range of technologies, and achieving net zero would mean implementing multiple technologies, so not just one, but a portfolio of technologies. Some technologies are quite straightforward, like growing biomass, planting trees, having more carbon in soils, for example, restoring habitats. But other technologies are a little bit more unusual, like grinding rocks to spread over agricultural land that has a possibility for also benefits for agriculture, but it's a little bit less advanced at the moment, or building what we call artificial trees, so filtering CO2, taking CO2 out of the atmosphere and storing it on the ground. By and large, the technologies that have the most potential also need the development of carbon capture and storage, so infrastructure for putting CO2 underground and keeping it there. We have looked in our report at numbers, so we provided estimates for each technology. We looked at whether the technologies are ready or not ready, and when will they be ready, how much will they cost. And we see that on cost, for example, with a carbon price of $50 to $100 per ton of CO2 removed, then many of the technologies become economically viable.